Hello everyone, welcome to what's probably now episode 2 of the Bank Vlog.
Voltage Vlogs.
The Voltage Vlogs,
Officially branded, as everyone knows.
Hashtag
brand everything. We did one trip, as you've known, to Hobson's Farming, just in, like, outside of York. But then this is the first proper big journey that media team's doing.
Scary.
Well, so what we're doing is we're doing a few different trips today. We're actually putting it through its paces. We're going from the office to Harrogate. We're going to an airfield so Rich can go fly his helicopter.
Don't say that, man. You're on the ground, mate.
Yeah, you're the one who's going in the sky, putting yourself in.
Due to weight restrictions, I couldn't take it, Rob said.
No, exactly. They said, no one that good looking can be in an air.
We can't ensure your pace.
Yeah, exactly. So we're going there, then we're going up to Boroughbridge to see a client. We're going to hand over some Phase 4 faceplates. And then we're heading right down to Leicestershire, which is going to be the big slog from Boroughbridge. Oh yeah, we're stopping off in Leeds as well to drop a lens back off. I think we should, if I've calculated it right, this calculation, we should be okay. We should need to charge. But we might charge as well because we haven't actually experienced it.
Yeah, and as well, ideally, if we can get there with like half a battery, so tomorrow when we get up at whatever time to go do the job in the morning in Leicester, we'll have a bit of battery rather than having to faff around in the morning, getting up early, finding somewhere to charge, hanging around for half an hour.
Then, obviously, after we filmed at the job, it's back up to the office, which, you know, maybe we'll do that in another.
As well. How long's it ride to Leicester?
So I figured it out. From Boroughbridge, it's going to take, from Leeds, it's going to take 120 miles. If you do want to know more about the van and stuff like that, and you think, oh, they're not actually explaining themselves too much, there will already be a video released where we go through details of exactly what's in the van, the very first EV van that's been built from the ground up to be an EV van, so make sure you check that out if you're interested about the stats and statistics. We'll make sure we link it as well, and yeah, we'll just see how we go.
Bye.
Bonus trip on the van journey. We've actually got to go back to the office now because it's so sunny out. We need to go get some sunglasses for the camera.
Oh, of course, yeah.
So we need to go get things called ND filters, which is Neutrogena. Neutrogena, yeah. Neutral density? Negative density? Anyway, ND filters, and they're basically sunglasses for your camera. So we're just. Gotta fly back there real quick and then up to Boroughbridge for 2 o'clock. First journey's done all right though on it.
116 miles in the tank. Yeah, we're still alive. Rob doesn't get my computer if I died in the helicopter crash. I had all faith in you, Rich, but you never know.
Messing about with the new slider today as well. We'll make sure we get the vlog on that as well.
Oh.
Very nice. We're just watching some pheasants
nearly
flying
to
the road. Could have been tea.
Eco vans are environmentally friendly to you, killer pheasant.
Yeah. Anyway, right, we're gonna cut it off and just let you know about the bonus journey. The real test and meat of it's all gonna come to when we're driving down to Leicester and we are anticipating a charge
somewhere.
Even if we don't necessarily need one, I think we'll do one anyway.
We'll be stopping for food, no doubt. So
yeah. So yeah, we'll see you back then.
Peace. Buenos dias from the van. Hello. We've just finished filming in Boroughbridge.
Yeah.
Little story for you. Boroughbridge.
Which way is it going
to
be?
I don't know. Boroughbridge.
Oh,
it's going to be hard to edit all the wipes back. But anyway, so we went to Boroughbridge. We did some filming there.
We filmed, you'll have known the property. We've done a couple of videos on it. We've basically finished off, but we were just putting in some face plates. Lovely antique.
Hashtag phase four.
Yes, they are now available through AS Distribution, so get on that.
Yeah.
But
little story for you.
So we basically thought, right, we're at a client's house. He had an outdoor wall socket, just a standard plug for your outdoors. You know, sometimes you want to do that. And he was like, oh, should we plug the car in? So we thought, yeah, we'll do that. Get some extra miles.
A couple of hours, you know, 2 hours. Yeah, right. Ten, twenty miles, two hours, maybe, reasonable.
You know, knowing that it is a 2 kilowatt charge, and we got exactly, I think, maybe
1 mile.
1 mile, maybe two.
1 mile, yeah. We got. That's like 1 hour 45, 2 hours in a wall charge. We got us 1 mile. Yeah, so wall charges, unless you're leaving it overnight. No.
Even then, so basically, before we haven't got, we're getting a couple of Zappy 2s courtesy of My Energy. Thank you, My Energy, for that. They're getting installed at AOS Academy and AOS HQ. And right now, we don't have them there because we've just been so busy and overwhelmed with lots of stuff, getting a bit of reach in there, that we just haven't had time to get them installed. But I thought, right, we'll just plug it into the wall. And I left it all day, started charging it about 10 in the morning. And Rich was the last one to leave the office. Everyone knows Rich, he leaves at stupid o'clock. Left at 11 o'clock. And it had about 136 miles in it. I thought, right, that's its capacity. But I'm now thinking, there's a level we haven't touched yet on it.
Yeah.
So it'll be interesting to see once we've got some rapid charges and once we, you know, do that. But I think the lesson on this bit is, if it's a wall socket, absolute last point of call.
Yeah, and yeah, if you're leaving it for, you know, a few hours, like, oh, I'm just gonna go do this job, it's gonna be 2 or 3 hours, pretty much no point, really.
No point, no. It's just, you know, maybe.
You need that big juicy power.
Get on ZapMap, so we're using ZapMap now. We're going to be charging on the way down to Leicester after we stopped off at Leeds, and we're going to find ourselves some rapid chargers.
But yeah, currently got 73 miles in the tank, so
and 110 to Leicester.
I think that's going to be a definitely. We're going to be stopping regardless.
We kind of knew that.
Yes, yeah. Like I mean, just for food generally. Like even if we didn't stop for a charge, we'd be stopping for some. Up, so
definitely tea time.
But we're 100% gonna aim for somewhere. Well, first, most importantly, Rob, that's got good food.
Yeah.
I mean,
some of that can accommodate.
I'll take a 2 kilowatt charger, you know, to get good food.
No, I would sacrifice a half decent meal. I'd have a packet of Polos if it meant that we could have a charge for a 50 kilowatt charger. Yeah.
So yeah.
We'll check back in with you next time. We'll be stopping off, I imagine. So
yeah. But excuse the sunglasses as well. We're not trying to be, we are cool. We're not trying to be cooler. It's just very sunny.
I mean, when you look like this,
you can't not
represent.
Yeah. So that's all the news for you. So we'll see you soon.
Sad Rob.
No, not sad Rob, just...
He's sad Rob.
He's tired.
Rob's sad.
Yeah, so basically, right, we've stopped off and we've got to the charge point. Yeah, so that's the Mackies that we've... If you get out, fuck us.
Let's have a look.
We've got a genius charge point. We're just outside Barnsley, basically.
Barnsley?
And we've stopped off, so we've tried to put the duo in, which gives us basically it's like two charge points and they're fitting both here, but this has not worked after multiple times of trying it. So what we've ended up doing is just going with a standard AC type 2. It's 7 kilowatt less hours, and then we've had to download the map.
54 kilowatts in this bad boy. 53.4.
So for rounding, it's down. So then we've also got the Genie Point app here. So this is basically just telling us
how much is going in, how much it's costing, and how long it's taking. What it's not telling us is how long it's gonna take.
Yeah, and we didn't even think as well, basically. If we turned up to this charger and someone was here,
we wouldn't have been able to go
anywhere.
Sat around waiting,
dossing about,
not knowing if it's charged up because we've never charged it. It's saying how many kilowatts are going in, but we don't know how many we then need to have a sufficient enough charge to get out of here.
Yeah, we're going to aim for like 40, 45, and we're at like 3.
Yeah, so it sounds like it's going to take a while.
Yeah, but thankfully, you can see over there through the trees.
Some golden arches. We might have to take the trip over.
Yeah, the Morrisons. Look at the beautiful sunset, though. It looks pretty.
I mean,
yeah.
It's a nice enough day for it, but you know, at the Morrisons. Same time, we're here. It's that old thing, isn't it, where you're not sure if you want to get an EV vehicle, and this is something you've definitely got to think about considering, especially if you're a tradie.
And we were saying as well, what's annoying is like, look at all this real estate. Look at all the space I had on here. All this space, and they put one charger in, like literally just one charge point. Like, you could have put four along here, do you know what I mean? Or at least a couple, so when it breaks, there's a backup. Because if this breaks, then that's it. There's not many, like, around Barnsley, really, is it? There was like two.
There was, yeah, to where we needed to get to, there was like two, but we needed to stop off for some food as well.
Yeah, so. And the thing is, like, the other ones that we've seen, they were just in the middle of nowhere. Like,
yeah.
Like, the good thing about this one was, although some, you know, it's broke, which is a given, it's near food, it's near a supermarket, which are places we had to kind of stop on the way anyway.
We
so
can keep ourselves entertained enough that we can, you know,
not go crazy.
But you know, at the same time, we're like, we're going to a hotel. We'd like to get there as soon as possible
because we're up early,
and. You know, it's just like one of those things at the end of the day. Normally, if you're, you know, getting to a fuel station, pump and dump, full tank, pump and dump, full tank, 5 minutes, quote that.
Pump and dump.
Quote me on that.
Quote right here.
And then you're on your way.
Yeah, we were saying every petrol station should have at least one of these.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it'd be ideal to be on the motorway, pulling to any service station, you just know, oh yeah, there's definitely a charge point there.
We've had to get the Zap map up.
We have come out of the way as well. We've drove like 10 minutes off the motorway, off the direction we were going.
Yeah, we've gone the wrong direction for a bit just to get to a charge point, a rapid charge point, even the rapid.
And now it's not rapid.
Yes.
So we come out of the way for nothing.
Maybe we give it
sad Rob, time, sad cam for now. What are we on at the minute, charge-wise, on the thing? Rob's just pulling out his two phones.
Multiple phones, you know.
His burner phone.
It, so we're there.
Now we're two.
Wait, it's going to catch up.
2.44. And we need to get close to like 35.
And that's taken 23 minutes to get there. So that's a long...
It's like...
It's
like
be
one every
time.
10 minutes.
Yeah. So it's trying to say that we're going to be here for an awful long time, is what it's saying.
Oh dear.
So
we might try the other one again. Do you want to do it before we go to the shop now? Try it on camera.
Right. So what we're going to do is we're going to stop that. That's been sent.
Oh, charge terminating. Please unplug your vehicle. It's counting down, Rob. Says you've got 15 seconds. Oh no, it's counting down until you can unplug it, I think.
Until I can unplug it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So it's saying I've done 26.1. So.
Yeah. What's that one? What's the other one?
It's a charger that we do not have the socket for. This is a socket we have. Plug that in.
Give it a good old. Oh.
Give it a what? Not that phone. That phone. Start a charge. So we're there. The type we want is a DCCCS. Start charge. Click to begin.
Please.
You're going to hear it clunk in a second.
Please. Please, so, please give us a fast charge, please.
So I don't know if that.
No!
It's doing bits. Please, please work. Please, fast charger.
This, after this countdown, should it work?
No. We got it.
I've never been so happy.
So you need to get to this screen.
Oh my god, it's work.
You can hear that going.
Yeah,
that,
listen, get a bit close for you.
You hear that?
I mean, it wasn't making that noise before.
I want to walk away slowly from this.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to cut it and we're going to leave that for 5 minutes and see if that's like...
That's probably going, isn't it?
We're going to see if that's like significantly faster because it's the combo I'd imagine it would be.
You have no idea how happy I am that it's...
It's slowing down, but maybe that's just because it's getting there. Green light flashing. That basically means they've got a good connection and we're charging up.
So now we're going to go to Morrison's.
Yeah, we're going to go to Morrison's.
And buy some snacks.
Come back and...
Look at the sky, Rob. Yeah. Look how pretty it looks.
I mean, we've turned a corner clearly today.
Yeah, everything. Now everything's great. Everything's EV van's mint. Charging station's mint, Genie. Don't worry about it. It's fine. We forgive you.
I don't want to speak too soon on behalf of...
No, yeah. We'll confirm that later. So, see you later. So I'll give you a bit of an overview of what happened since the last time I've seen us. So, on the way to Leicester, stopped at the charger in Barnsley, got a full charge, pretty much everything is great. And then literally, on the motorway, the miles just start ticking down and ticking down a little bit faster than what like the projected miles were. So we were like, right, we're going to probably make it to the hotel here with about 20 miles left in us, which we did. Like, we got to the back of the hotel, we had 20 miles. Looked on the map once we got to the hotel, there's a charge around the corner. It's literally 5 minutes to the Morrison's, and there's a charger there. Perfect. Shout out to Morrison's, by the way. Every Morrison's, pretty much, I think, has an electric charger in the car park. So, Morrison's, good on you. You'll have more of our business, I'm pretty sure, because we can't resist going in for a bite to eat usually.
We'll make sure there's more charges available.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's the thing that happened to us this morning. There's two kinds of chargers. There was a 50 kilowatt charger and a 22 kilowatt charger now. 22, you think half, it's half the speed. Yeah, it's significantly slower.
So yeah, we put to Morrison's, like running on fumes basically. Obviously, we're like, oh yeah, we can spare half an hour, 40 minutes, get a decent bit of charge, blah, blah, blah.
Just so we can head to our job and then get back on the motorway straight away.
And then just find a charger on the way home.
So we got there, and it turns out that the charger we were looking for was already being used.
We were plugging for 5 minutes, well, 10, 15 minutes in this slow charger. It does nothing. It probably gives us about 5-6 miles in the space of like 20.
About half an hour we were there for.
Yeah, and it gave us like 5 miles. So again, it's just pointless unless you're there overnight.
Drew had a bit of a revelation and said, why don't...
the revelation.
Drew had this revelation.
I had a revelation. Yeah, the lads on site could just, you know, drive behind us to the Morrison's. We could leave the van for an hour at Morrison's, get a bite to eat. So, Drew had... I had a revelation. and said, okay, we'll get the lads from site to follow us to Morrison's. We can then leave the van for an hour, let it charge up, fingers crossed the charge is free. Then they can run us back to site, and then we can go back in an hour to pick it up and get some lunch at the same time. So in the end, that worked perfectly.
And then what we decided was, right, after we've learned from our mistakes, we're now going to not do one big charge. We're going to do one little charge halfway on the motorway. So after our full tank, we stopped at Woodall Services, shout out Woodall Services, on the northbound M1. And it was one of those where nipped in, used the toilet, got a coffee, come back out, it's been 20 minutes, and we've charged up to 80% back on the road. It was
the smoothest experience of any charge we've used. There was two of them there with two ports each.
Now with that little bit of extra charge we've got, it's going to get us home
easily
with 50 miles left in the tank. You know, so
it's one of those I think we're now going to learn from those mistakes there. I don't know if you've noticed, Cam, but I've been a bit in a huff today.
Oh, Rob's been brutal today, honestly. He's so moody. He's tired. He's like, oh, man.
I'm tired. I'm hot and bothered. And then
and everything kept running out of batteries today. So our whole life just was revolved around electricity.
We got the day done. Run away home. Friday is not the feeling right now. But
like, that's Tuesday feeling. If we were to do this journey again, I think the two things we'd do differently would be,
number one,
leave on a full charge. Always leave on a full charge. Even if you have to start your journey half an hour later than you anticipated, leave on full charge.
And then number two, we would say make sure that you don't do one big stop, do a few little stops if you have to. It's going to be more efficient and it's going to seem like it's going much quicker if you're just plugging in a couple of times. Notice your clocks at maybe 80 miles down, try and look for a services on the way there, get it charged up. You might think, I've got 80 miles in the tank, that's absolutely bullshit. What you're talking about, trust me, you'll want to do that. You'll get up to 80% in about 15-20 minutes and you'll be back on the road like
And the final takeaway, something that we only learned after we were inconvenienced by it, on ZapMap and any other service, you can usually check if the charges are in use. Now, it's not always going to be perfect. Like, you know, we left the hotel in that 15-minute gap between us checking, somebody could have used the charger. But, you know, it's always good just to check. And as well, always try and stop off in places with a couple of chargers, because there's nothing worse than, you know, you're at the place, you've done the stop, you're fully prepared to stop there, and the charge is taken, and there's nothing you can do about it.
They got their first, they're charging, yeah. You can't push them on their way, you know, and then it is what it is, and it's just, you know, you can't, it's one of these things.
Gutting, it's gutting, that's what it is. It is properly gutting, yeah. And just to be clear as well, like, there's no gripes with the van, I don't know if you agree, like, the van itself, it's fine, like it does the miles it says it'll do. The range could be bad, but you know, you could always, no matter how many miles you're gonna get a range, you'll always
say that about every single range could always be bad.
The issue is with the charging stations, not being enough chargers, faulty chargers, which we've not experienced yet, even though we thought we had one.
We've seen
plenty of reports about
that. Yeah. There are lots of reports of people saying the chargers just aren't working, and I think the reports are going in because maybe one's not working, but there's not another one available to them. So the one place that they need to charge, they now can't charge.
But yeah, we'll hopefully see you next time. Yeah. Leaving on a full charge, charging a bit more frequently rather than trying to drain the battery fully and then charge it up fully. But yeah, the van, honestly, it's fine, can't fault it at all. It's just the chargers.
There are some takeaways that we will be doing. We'll do a video at the end of this vlog series, and we're going to give you our final thoughts and takeaways about what we like about this van, what we think we can change about this van, what should be changed about this van,
what should be changed about the charging network,
change about the network and stuff. And we're just going to give you our honest opinions from people that have come from not owning any electric vehicles, purely combustion engines.
Being dropped in the deep end.
Basically. Really dropped in the deep end, don't work in it. So, yeah, if you keep an eye out, again, if you want to learn more about the van, there's a different video. We'll put a link down for you there.
And subscribe to the channel, you'll keep up with all our lovely journeys and hilarities, we'll say. Right, peace, see you later.